My name is Leonard Husvogt, and hello and welcome to our video presentation for our abstract Maximum a posteriori signal recovery for OCT angiography image generation. This is based on an article we recently published in Biomedical Optics Express. In the introduction, I will briefly describe the usual process of generating optical coherence tomography angiography, or OCTA for short, volumes from OCT scans. Then I will describe the MAP estimate we use for reconstruction and the experiments. In addition to that, generating a suitable ground truth for evaluation posed a particular challenge in our case. I will then show some of our results, followed by the conclusion. OCTA is an established method for imaging the retinal vasculature in patients who suffer from diseases like age-related macular degeneration, diabetic retinopathy, macular edema, among others. OCTA is non-invasive compared to methods like fluorescein angiography, which require the injection of contrast agents. In order to compute OCTA volumes, on the right, regular OCT volumes are scanned with the same B-scan, the red line or red slice, is scanned multiple times in quick succession. Aside from noise, any kind of motion can cause changes in the OCT data over time. Blood flow down to the capillary level is sufficient to cause these changes in OCT. Established methods then compute OCTA from OCT and are, for instance, amplitude decorrelation or speckle variance. Because OCT is noisy, OCTA contains a lot of noise too. So far, to the best of our knowledge, common approaches to denoising OCTA data are basic filter operations like 3D median filters or thresholding based on the structural data. While these approaches already achieve significant improvements, further improvements could be made by looking into more sophisticated methods that do not require changes to the device or imaging protocols. Our approach is to treat the computation of OCT angiography as a reconstruction problem and use a MAP estimate for performing reconstruction and denoising based on a Bayesian signal model by Plona et al., which uses a maximum likelihood estimate. This model provides a theoretical basis for a data consistency term for reconstruction, but does not improve image quality by itself. By including prior knowledge through regularizers, we extended the signal model to a maximum a posteriori estimate. We use the gradient from the maximum likelihood estimate together with a regularizer, such as total variation or wavelet shrinkage. As in a simple iterative approach. The objective is to maximize the probability of the reconstructed OCTA volume X given the observations of the structural OCT volume Y. These are our repeated B scans over time. Parameters are the step size lambda for the update step, the regularizer and its associated parameters, and the total number of iterations. The OCTA volume X is initialized using one of the OCTA formulas. The regularizer and the update step are then in turn applied for a preset amount of iterations or until the volume X, the reconstructed volume X, does not change anymore. This gradient is based, according to Plona's model, on amplitude correlation or interframe variance or speckle variance. The output is our reconstructed volume X hat. Evaluating the performance of our iterative reconstruction is not straightforward. The lack of a ground truth with little noise poses a significant challenge. In order to obtain a ground truth, we acquired six X and Y fast scan pairs of a volunteer's eye, these in the center, where every B scan was repeatedly scanned 10 times. In practice, this would lead to an overly long scan time and patients' eyes would exhibit too much motion. But this problem can be mitigated with a young, healthy volunteer with good fixation. Using a subset of the 10 scans, instead of using all 10 repeats, we can decide to use fewer, like 3, 5, or 10. This allows us to test reconstruction. To obtain a ground truth, we co-registered and merged all six OCTA scan pairs using the motion correction algorithm by Kraus and Plona et al. This allowed us to obtain high quality OCTA volume with low SNR. because OCTA volumes are not used directly usually, but a projection of vascular layers instead, we segmented and projected the retinal vasculature for the evaluation. And we did that for our volumes used in reconstruction and for our ground truth volume. This is the structural volume, but which is not relevant in our case. This table shows results for the reconstruction compared against the ground truth. Initial OCTA on the left refers to images computed using amplitude correlation and interframe variance, so without our reconstruction method. The rows correspond to the number of B-scans used for reconstruction or for the computation of the OCTA volumes. The other columns, wavelet shrinkage and total variation, indicate the regular risers used during reconstruction. And to compare to a widely used approach, we also compared against median filtered results. Here, the median filter was applied in 3D on the initial OCTA data. And the PSNR and structural similarity metrics compare against the ground truth. So we can see that in all instances, our reconstruction, as well as the median filter, already achieved significant improvements, especially for amplitude decorrelation, because amplitude decorrelation tends to be noisier than interframe variance. But overall, total variation seems to perform best, except in the case of interframe variance with only three repeats, where the median filter achieved the better PSNR result than the total variation. This slide shows how structure similarity and peak signal-to-noise ratio change during the reconstruction process. Using more B-scans leads to better results from the beginning, but the difference decreases during reconstruction. The top row shows the PSNR and decibel results. The lower row shows the structure similarity. The left half, we have wavelet shrinkage. On the right side, we do have total variation. And we can see that over the reconstruction iterations that the PSNR and structure similarity increase. And in some cases, they can get very close. The fact that we can get into similar ranges is important because if less B-scans are needed, imaging times will be shorter, which makes imaging of patients generally easier because patients have problems fixating or are older and their eyesight tends to be worse. Here we see on fast projections for interframe variance reconstructions. The top row shows the original amplitude decorrelation on fast projections. The center row shows the total variation regularized results, and the bottom row shows median filtered results as for comparison. On the right, we see the unfast projection of the ground truth plus an enlarged area from the same ground truth. And we can see that compared to the initial unfast views, we get significantly reduced noise and some of the vessels start to become more apparent. We don't reach the quality of the ground truth, but we can see even very fine capillaries, but some vessels are easier to see than here. And on top of that, the median filter actually tends to blur out very small capillaries, which decreases vascular connectivity. In summary, we developed a new map estimate-based data consistency term for iterative reconstruction of OCTA volumes. To the best of our knowledge, this is the first reconstruction of OCTA volumes based on Bayesian statistics. Generally, total variation seems to outperform wavelet regularization. Thank you so much for your attention, and feel free to check out our paper in Biomedical Optics Express. Thank you.